so quick run through. We got five ways to play the melody lick here on the B, 5-7. Well, we got the chord one up here. Got the root one, or we got the chord riff one, or we got the high one, and then we got three different ways to do the walk down, or six ways to play the A minor riff, or, and then we have three ways to do the A minor moving. The stagnant, or we can add pull-offs, or we can do up here. So that's it, and then that's mixed in with doing any way you want. Okay, here we are at the instrumental part at the end that is so famous. I'm going to teach it to you down low, and then I'll show you where Jerry plays it around the neck and whatnot. So the first section is what I call the signature lick. Right? It's always followed by a walk down, which will be nine notes, three sets of three, which he does over different places and different starting points. And then that'll always end up on an A minor riff, which he can do anyway. I'll show you six places he does that. And then there's also then what I call the moving A minor riff, which is a and that is A minor G A or C So it's A minor, G, C, E minor, G, to D. So that signature lick is always on D. So you got that walking. So you got the signature lick, a walk down, an A minor riff, riff, A minor, G, C, E minor, G, D, back to the signature riff, again an A minor riff, and then the main A minor riff, which I call up with the melody lick. So that the main A minor versus the moving A minor, the main A minor riff, we call it, base it all off of an open D chord that everybody should know, and do this little riff that everybody probably has tried a million times, where you strum, you lift your second finger and have a open E, and then while it's ringing, you hammer to that second finger. That's kind of how this melody lick starts. So, if you were doing notes, you'd do that. But you can do it on a D chord. And then you'd go, which is an open E to the second E to the third E. Then when you hit the third, pull off second open. So it's open to third to open. And then go to the second. And again, you can do that. That's on the third note of the scale. Third, third, second, third, fourth, second, third. Do it anywhere. So, and or he'll do it the harmony, which Bob or him will do randomly on, is just to do it on the D note. So while one of them might be going, the other one will be doing it, which is a lot easier to do up here. But for demonstration, since we're on this D chord, put your second finger on the B string, third fret, and then go first fret, third fret, fifth, third, first. It's quite a stretch for me. So 3, 3, 2, 3, 5, 3, 1. So it's, excuse me, I don't know what I just said. So it's 3, 3, 1, 3, 5, 3, 1, 3, 3, 3, 1, 3, 5, a lit, 5, 3, 1, 5, a lit, 5, a lit, 3, 3, 3, 1, 3, 5, 3, 1, 3, 1, 3, 5, a lit, 3, or. So you do that same thing up on the E string, 10th fret, 2nd finger. A lot easier right there. But anyway, just to show you how it lies in a D chord, he can go to the 3rd. Or do it with the root. Okay? And then it's always followed by a walk down again, which he can do two ways. He can start on the 4th note, or you can start on the second note, would be the harmony for it. So I'll show you those notes down there. So first walk down is E string, 3-2 open, and then 2 open to the 3rd on the B, and then open E, 3rd B, 1st B, and then an A minor chord. So it's 3-2 open, 2 open, 3 open, 3, 1, A minor chord. So 3-2 open, 2 open, 3 open, 3, 1, A minor. Or the alternate method, like I said, is to go down a step to open E. And those notes are open E to 3rd, 1st on B, and then 3rd, 1st, open on the B. So, open, 3-1, 3-1, open, which is 1 on the B, open B, open G. And then you can kind of hammer on to an A minor. So, pick which ones they do, and it'll randomly be harmony or unison between him and Bob. So then you get to, so again, and when you do those up here, exact same thing, just of 12 frets. But we'll get to that. So, then there is the those four chords. Which is actually A minor, G, D, C, but he picks through them this way. So this is for the main lick. What again is? So A minor, G, D, C, but these are the precise notes, which is the, just trace an A minor chord. You're going D string 2, G string 2, B string 1. And then open B, open G to the second D. Open B, open G, second D. So you're going second D, second G, first B, open B, open G, second D. And then the D is open D, fourth D, second G. Open 4, D, second G. So, and then open G, second, D, third A, like a C chord. Open, 2-3, open, 2-3. So it's, okay, so, but he does it up here, and I'll show you. Okay, so, but that's, those are the notes. And then it always ends up with a A minor, and you can go, and then it'll be a, which is an A minor, where you're then lowering the D string from second to first, keeping everything else at the top. And then it's a D, and then he does this lick, which you can do it anywhere, but I'll just teach it down here again. So it's open E, second E, open A, second A, open D. So D, and then the melody lick, wherever you want to do it. Okay, so again, four. So that main lick is, and then it'll go, I left that part out, which is A,
thank you.
Okay, so those are the four parts. It's got the melody lick, the walk down, an A minor riff, and then a walking A minor riff, melody, another walk down, another A minor riff, then the A minor main riff. To the melody, and that's the whole pattern. Walking A minor, melody, walk down, A minor riff, main riff. So if you just did the next time it comes around, you'll end up doing the walking one instead. Okay, so we're going to break it down into five parts, which would be the melody lick, a walk down, an A minor stagnant riff, and then an A minor either walking or main. That would be the walking, or if it would go to the main, it would be the long one. That is then the main, so there's really just five separate, so you can literally play everything right down here without going above the fourth fret. Okay, well, I'm going to show different ways to play the melody lick. In addition to the one down there I showed you. So, first one would be which is 5th fret, B, hammer into 7, do it twice, and then 5, 7, 8, 7, 5, 7. And whether you choose to do the hammers, or just go, or, doesn't really matter. So that's the first melody lick. Next time it comes up, I'm going to have you go, which is like a D shape. So if you're doing a D bar chord, you're just doing the middle of it with the D, G, B on the 12, 11, 10 on the 3rd, 2nd, and 1st fingers. But you slide to it from a C shape. So you're going 10, 9, 8. Up to 12, 11, 9. I'm sorry, 10, 9, 8 to 12, 11, 10. So you started on a C shape, 10, 9, 8, sliding up to 12, 11, 10. So then you do it again. Okay, so that's C, D, C, D, G, D, which is just lay your 3rd finger flat on 12 on the D, G, and B. So, Okay, so you got this one on the 7th B. Or you could do it here. Okay, and then the third time it comes along, we're going to do it on the E string with the root note, which is E string, 8, hammer to 10, twice, 8, 10, 11, 12, 10, 8, as a pull up. So it's 8, 10, 8, 10, 8, 10, 12, 10, 8, 10. So we got, we also got, and now we got, so there's three different ways to do that melody lick. The fourth way would be just a variation of that, where we're just going to take, and we're just going to turn that one into a riff, and just do the G string 9 first finger, B string 10 second finger, hit them both, hammer to the third finger, G string 11, do it twice, and then you can go, which is just G string 9, 11, 12, 11, 9 to 11. Okay, so that's four ways we're doing it. We're doing it here. We're doing it here. We're doing it here. And now we're doing it here. Got one more way to show you, which is like the D one we did down here. Except we're going to move that up to the 14th, 15th, and 14th on the G, B, and E. And hit it twice. So you're doing the same thing as, but you're doing it up here, and then, so you go 12th fret, first finger, 14th fret, second finger, 15th fret, pinky, pulling off to the third, pulling off to the first, then back to the third finger, 14th fret. So you're doing the chord, 12, 14, 15, 14, 12, 14, so those are five different ways that I'm going to incorporate into this massive, or this lesson plan, I guess you could say. So the first one is on the B, 5th to 7th. The next one was a chord shape up here on the D, G, and B, sliding from the C to the D. C, D, C. Third one was the root one on the 10th fret E, and then the fourth one was the riff one off of a D chord. Okay, and then the last one was the, okay, now as far as the walk downs go, I'm going to show you again. So when he does this one, that leaves him open for, which is 8-7-5 on the B, 7-5 on the B, 7 on the G, 5-7-5 on the B, G. So it's 8-7-5 on the B, 7-5 B, 7 G, 5 B, 7 G, 5 G. So that's the one way that they do the walk down. Another way that he does the walk down is, so remember we were doing, so the walk down would be, so you go 12, 10, 8 on the E, shift your hand to the pinky on 10, 10, 8, 7. So 12, 10, 8, 10, 8, 7, and then 8, 7 on the E to 8 on the B. So that would be the second way to do that walk down. First way, second way, and then a third way to do the walk down is the same notes, but you're doing it off an A minor shape. So you're doing first finger on E string 12, pinky on B string 15 to 13. Second finger. So it's 12 E, 15, 13 B, and then 15, 13, 12 B. So 15, or 12, 15, 13, 15, 13, 12, 13, 12, 12. So 13, 12 on the B, 12 on the G. 13, 12 B, 12 G. So it's, that sets you up for an A minor riff high, whereas the other one sets you up for an A minor riff low. So that's actually just three ways to do the, we're going to do the walk down. It's either going to be, or, or, so three different ways. So far we've got, when he does the melody down here, he can follow it up with that walk down, and then when they do the melody up here, they could do the, if he wants to end up low again, or if he's up here, he'd go to the A minor shape if he wants to end up high. So so we've got five ways to play the melody, three ways to play the walk down, and then we get to the A minor riff, which I do one there, also do one here, and also do one here. And then a third way we would play it is, a fourth way with an arpeggio. Okay, so we've got six ways to play this stagnant A minor riff. I got a low one here. Okay, so we got three ways to play the stagnant A minor riff. Low like this, or low like this, mid. Or a third way, adding a blues lick. Or we can go up here and do that. Or we can do that and add an arpeggio to the end. Or we can do that and add a flourish to the end. So six ways. Or that with an arpeggio. Or that with a flourish. Way to play the would be hit open A and first finger on 5th fret D and then hammer to the 7th fret D, then strum sippy one sippy, do the same thing. So he's another way would be just first finger flat on a third fret, B and E, hitting it and sliding up to the fifth and doing that's a second way to play it. Or we can do that way and add a blues lick to it. Which is taking the G string, third finger, seventh fret, bending it up, laying the first finger flat on B and E. Triplet twice, triplets, triplet, triplet, and then this triplet. So G strings, seven up and down real quick, pull off to five, and then hit seven on D, and then if you got time, do the open A5 hammer to 7. So that's what I call the low or the mid or the mid with a blues lick. Okay, and then if fourth way to play that riff is up here on the A minor chord. Okay, so that's just taking your first finger on G string 12, second finger on B string 13, and hammering to G string 14 on your third finger, and then going back to your A minor shape for the strum. Okay, and then the fourth way, or I'm sorry, the fifth way, is to start like that, and then do this arpeggio. Which would stay, put your first finger flat on the G string 12, slide up to 14, then hit 14D and 14G again. like as a triplet. So 12 slide to 14 on the G with the first finger, then play 14 again on the DG, and then pinky on the 17, 14, 17, pinky first, pinky on the G. So and then which would be again pinky laid down flat on 17, 17B, 17G, 17B, and then 17E to end it. You can finger pick it. So 12 slide to 14 G, 14 D, 14 G, 17 14, 17 G, 17 17, 17 B, G B, and then 17 E to end it. So starting it out with okay, and then the last way is when he does just a little flourish. So he'll go. So again, start it out the same with the riff, and then go triple it one, and then go up to the 17th fret, whether you use your pinky or third finger. But just lay it flat on the G, B, and E, and do it like a flourish. So it's like. So there's six ways. Which is that or just a slight variation of it. Which is just the A minor, G, C, E minor, G, or hammering on or pulling off on those chords. Or one more which he does high. So you can go 14, 13, 12 on the G, B, E, just like top of an A minor. And then lay your first finger flat on 12, 12, 12 on the D, G, B. Three more. Then C is 14, D, 12, G, 13, B. Do it three times. So we're going A minor, G, 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 C, C, C. 14, 12, 13, and then the E minor is played 12B, 12G, 14D. So, and then the G is just flat first finger on the D, G, and B. And then, so it's you can pull off on the... So that is just... You start at the same... But instead of having your first finger on the 12th, you just lay your first finger flat like a little bar chord on the G, B, and E. And just pull off on that 14 G and to 12 and the 13 B to 12. And then you can do the similar thing on the C, which is pulling off on the B string 13 to 12. So, oops. So, just the basic one. Basic. Or modified a little bit. So he doesn't always do the most complicated way. He'll do more basic sometimes, just to set it off. So, but then this last one, so that is just, you know, use any finger, pinky or third finger, flat on the 15th B and E, or yeah, and go slide up to 17, 15 sliding to 17, double strings. So you go, so then you slide back down. Okay. Then you'll do 17 sliding up to 20 and slide down to 19. So. And then end up on 15. And then. So it's. So three ways to play that. The straight, or with the pull-offs, or up high. Okay. Then we get to the E main lick for the first time. The one that went... So, the way he does it up on the neck is he hits so he hits open A and hammers that to the 7th fret A. He's tracing A minor here at the bottom of it, so he's going open, hammer to 7, 3rd finger, pinky down on the 7th fret D, 1st finger down on the G string 5th. And then come back and hit the 5th fret D again. Open, I meant 7th fret G, or D, dang. Okay, open, 7 A, 7 D, 5 G, back to 7 D. And 1, 2, and open 7, 7, 5, 7. first finger, D5 second finger, you're doing an E minor triad, and so pinky on the A seventh. So you did a little hand shift there, so you're going. And you can do a grace note. Slide into that hammer. Okay, so that's open, hammer to seven on the A, seven on the D, five G, seven D, and then four, five, seven on the G, D, A. Part. Again, you're hammering from the A to the fifth with your pinky this time. And going then 4-2-4 on the D, G, D with the third, first, and third fingers. Open, hammer 5. Coming off of and then end it, which is open G, second fret D, third fret A, open A, like as a pull off. So coming after. And then, which is, you're going to an A minor, but you're hitting the D string. Open hammer 1-2 with the first and second fingers, and then B1 and then G2 with the third finger. Open 1-2, 1B, second G. Fingers are on an A minor chord, and then he'll either do a triplet, or he'll do two triplets. So, okay, or so he'll either go triplet, or he'll go triplet. And do it both times. Two triplets. Or one triplet. So then. Then, what I was saying earlier about the A minor, doing your hand. minor, and then just go second chord there, just first finger D string, keeping the rest of what you already had, which is second fret G and first fret B. So it's open A, first fret D, second fret G, first fret B. So it's coming up. And then just a regular D. Like I said, open two on the E and the A to the open D. So that's all the main lick. Come in with a melody somewhere. Okay, so for purposes of this lesson, and another thing, that's the fancy way. He might just leave some of those notes out of there, like those open notes, and just go. Instead of, he'd just go, just leaving some of the notes out, making it simpler. So he improvises on how he does that main riff every time. So I just showed you the main way, and then he subtracts from that if he wants. So you don't have to do that last note. You could just go, and then you don't have to hammer or play that last note. You could just go, just 5-4-2. So. Or mix and match them. So. Just like this, that lick he can do up here. Okay, she's coming off of.